Every time you take a pill with a sip of water, it seems simple, but the real mystery is, how does a pill actually cross from your gut into your blood? That's the magic of drug absorption in the gastrointestinal tract, and today we will uncover the mechanisms that make it possible. Drug absorption is the movement of unchanged drug from site of administration to systemic circulation. It's an important part of pharmacokinetics ADME concept, in which A stands for absorption, D distribution, M metabolism, and E excretion. Check out our pharmacokinetics video for more details. Oral route of absorption may result in inefficient and erratic drug therapy. Whenever a drug is ingested orally, we would like it to have rapid and complete absorption into the bloodstream. Now back to the mechanisms of drug absorption, there is more than one way to classify mechanisms of oral drug absorption from the GIT. One easy, reliable way is the following. 1. Passive diffusion. 2. Carrier-mediated transport. 3. Vesicular transport. 4. Port transport. And 5. Ion bearer transport. But first, let's recall together the structure of the GIT cell membrane. It looks something like this, consisting of two layers, 1 and 2, together are called the phospholipid bilayer. The phospholipid structure is a head and a tail. The head is a polar phosphate and the tail are nonpolar fatty acids. Back to the cell membrane, as we said, we have polar head to the surface and a nonpolar tail in between. Different protein types like N-channel protein, peripheral protein, some cholesterol, carbohydrates, and a transmembrane glycoprotein, and some pores. Now, in order for the drug to be absorbed, it should be able to cross this membrane and reach the blood circulation by different mechanisms, starting with the passive diffusion. It is a passive process, which means it doesn't need any energy or ATP to take place. Its driving force is concentration gradient, which is the difference in drug concentration across the membrane. As we can see to the right, we have a high concentration, while to the left, we have low concentration. And this difference is the concentration gradient. And the net movement will be from high to low concentration spontaneously. Think of it as a slide, where high concentration is on top and low concentration at the bottom. Logically, the movement will be from high to low with no need for any ATP. So, to sum up, passive diffusion is the passing of the drug through the membrane. It's the most common mechanism of drug absorption in the GIT. The drug moves from high concentration to low concentration. It's a passive process, so no ATP is needed. It's not saturable, which means as long as concentration gradient exists, the movement continues. And lastly, it works best for lipid-soluble, small, non-ionized molecules. Another related concept is paracellular drug absorption, in which the drugs pass between cells, not through them as we can see. It's very limited because the gaps are tight, and only very small hydrophilic molecules can pass through tight junctions. For example, mannitol, when given orally, absorbed minimally and only through this paracellular route, which means mannitol has very, very low oral bioavailability. So far, we've seen how drugs can passively slip through cell membranes or sneak between cells. But not all drugs can rely on passive routes. Some need extra help to get in, and others even get bumped back out. Curious how? Then don't miss part 2, where we uncover the world of carrier-mediated transport and the tug-of-war between uptake and efflux transporters. Click the corner and let's continue the journey. If you learned something cool today, smash that like button and hit subscribe for more bite-sized medical lessons. Drop your answers and questions in the comments. Until next time, stay curious.